Hey everybody, welcome back. My name is Eric. I am an electronic music producer and performer from Denver, Colorado, and glad to have you here. Thanks for popping into to the video and to the channel. So today we're going to talk about MIDI. MIDI can be something that seems really complicated and overwhelming when you first start to get into it. I know it was for me for sure. Took a long time to really kind of not only sort out how it works, but how I could get it to work for me, how I could get it to work for the setup that I wanted to do and the way that I wanted to perform with my gear. So a few basics I wanna go over. We're not gonna talk about everything there is to know about MIDI, but I just wanna try and give you the best examples that I can of how I use it, how it worked for me, and maybe that can help you use it in your setup or to connect your gear that you have. Maybe you got your first hardware synth and you need to connect it, or maybe you got your second one and you need to figure out how to connect them together so they can talk to each other. Either way, hopefully this will give you some good information about that. So before we get started, just wanted to talk about, there's two kinds of MIDI in general. MIDI stands for Musical Instrument Digital Interface, and it's been around for a long time, for decades. And it's a way, it's a language basically for digital instruments to be able to speak to one another and tell each other to do things basically. In more recent years, there's been a movement from kind of a classic way of doing MIDI into using USB for MIDI. Now, what we're going to be talking about today is, for the most part, kind of the classic MIDI, which is called DIN MIDI, and not so much about the USB MIDI. USB MIDI is generally between hardware pieces of equipment, synthesizers or groove boxes or whatever, and your computer. You might want to connect, you know, a machine plus to your Ableton Live setup, and you would do that through USB MIDI, so you wouldn't have to do a lot of what we're going to talk about today. What this really works for is hardware gear when you're connecting one to another and when there's not a computer involved, and that's kind of the basis of this whole setup. So we will talk just a little bit about USB MIDI at one point, but for the most part it's going to all be DIN MIDI. Now, USB MIDI obviously uses a USB cable. You've seen these, they're kind of the standard cables. You probably got one connecting your computer to your printer at home if it's not Bluetooth. And same kind of cable that you would use to connect USB. One of the things that's important to know that is different between USB MIDI and DIN MIDI is that USB MIDI is bi-directional. So the signal flow passes in both directions. So if you have two pieces of equipment that are connected with this, they can talk back and forth to each other over one cable. Now, DIN MIDI, cable for DIN MIDI looks like this. If you notice on the inside, it's got five little prongs in there. Both sides look the same. This signal flow with DIN MIDI is monodirectional, meaning it goes from one place to another and that's it. So the signal flows in one direction. So one thing can tell another thing what to do or what it's just done or whatever, but the other thing can't tell it back on the same cable through the same signal flow. So that's one of the limitations of DIN MIDI and one of the things that makes things as complex as what we're gonna be talking about today. USB MIDI is a lot easier to connect because it is bi-directional. So you just plug them in and then you tell it what you want it to say back and forth. DIN MIDI doesn't quite work out that way. So we're going to talk a little bit about that. So basically with DIN MIDI, the way I have my setup set here, the Octatrack is kind of the brain of the whole operation. That's where the clock comes from. So the tempo to sync all of these instruments together, the program changes, the control changes, the things that tell different things what to do, when to start, when to stop, when to change patterns, things like that. That all comes from the Octatrack. So with that signal being an out signal, it's gonna come from an out port. Now there's three different kinds of ports in MIDI. And not all pieces of equipment have the same ports. So if we look at this Moog Minotaur, you'll notice on the back, there's just one port here. This is a single MIDI in. This means that with DIN MIDI, this can receive a signal only. So a keyboard, a sequencer, something else can tell this what to do and it will do it. Says play a C sharp, it will play a C sharp. But the signal flow comes into this from something else. The next type of connector, like what's on this this SH01A, if you look on the back here, this one has two connectors. So you have an in and an out, meaning that if you have a sequencer or a keyboard that is plugged into the input of this from their output, they will be telling this what to do, this synthesizer. So a sequencer can tell this synthesizer, play these notes in this pattern at this tempo. And that would be coming out from the sequencer into the import. This port going out means that this would then be telling something else what to do. So let's say we went from the out of this one into the input of the Moog Minotaur. The sequencer on here could tell the Moog Minotaur what to do while something else is telling the SH-01A what to do. So import and output here, and only an import in the Moog Minotaur. The third kind is what you would see in something like one of these Electron boxes. They all look the same. This one is the Digitone. This has three ports on the back. So if you look on the back, there is an in port, just like there was on the main the Moog Minotaur. There is an out port, just like there was on the Roland. And there is what's called a through port. That's the third kind. Each one of them serves a unique purpose. To explain to you a little bit about what it does, we've already talked about in, how that works, and out, how that works. What's unique about through is that if a signal is coming in to this box, and then you have the through connected to something else, the signal that was coming in is what will pass through this box to the next one in line. Without taking into consideration anything that's going on inside this box. So we could have a MIDI keyboard connected to the in of this box. From the out, we could connect from this box to, let's say, the Moog Minotaur, and the sequencer in this box could be telling the Moog Minotaur what to play in a sequence, while the keyboard into this is telling this what to play. If the through was going to another synthesizer or, you know, another, you know, sample player or something like that, that same keyboard signal that was coming into this is passing through to the next thing. So that keyboard could also be controlling something else down the line, down the chain of MIDI. And it wouldn't be affected by the out signal from the sequencer in this machine going out to the Minotaur, separate signal chains. The in passes through without being affected by what's going on inside here. Now, keeping those in consideration, we want to think about how we would connect different boxes or connect a flow of signal from one thing to another, and why would we need to do certain things? Well, obviously we wouldn't connect to the Moog Minotaur first if we needed to connect then to something else, because it doesn't have an out port. So we always have to keep in mind what ports are on the gear that we're going to connect, and keep in mind that DIN MIDI is monodirectional. So each out is going to an in on the other side, each in is coming from an out, and each through is that in signal passing through going somewhere else. So now if we want to connect different equipment, so we've got a whole bunch of different machines here that we want to connect together and have them do certain things together, certain things influenced by each other, how would we do that? And there's no one right way. What's interesting about this, so you have to kind of sit down and plan out, what do I need these things to do? What do I want to be the thing controlling what other things, and how do I do that? So a couple things to consider in that. When you're passing a signal path, you can do it a couple of different ways. The first way is what's called a daisy chain, where you will put an out from, let's say, a keyboard to an in on, let's say, the Digitone. Then you would pass from the through of the Digitone to the in on, let's say, the Octatrack or the Digitact. Okay, that same keyboard can then control both of those things. But how does each one of those things know which notes the keyboard wants each one to play? Well, that signal chain of MIDI is transmitting on 16 different channels at once. So what you would do is you would set up what channel you want a device to listen on. So let's say channel 16. And if you want a keyboard to play something in that box that's listening to channel 16, you would have that keyboard sending out those notes on channel 16. If you wanted the keyboard in that intermediary, the Digitone, and you wanted it to play some notes there, but not on the other one, maybe you have the Digitone listening to channel number 15. And the keyboard is set to send certain messages or the sequencer or whatever you've got connected on channel 15 to that unit. So as you're setting this up, each unit is going to have a certain channel that it's listening on. And each unit that's sending something out is going to be sending it out on different channels depending on what you want to hear it that's in that signal path. So what happens if you want all of them to hear the same thing? So what we would do in that case, for example, with the Octatrack being in charge of the tempo, control change messages, any of the pattern change messages, things like that are coming out of the Octatrack, and we want them to go to everything because we want everything to start and stop at the same time. We want everything to change tempo if we change tempo at the same time. So the way we would do that with only one out from the Octatrack and we need to go to multiple places is with a box like this. This one is called a quadra through. There's a lot of different ones. This one's quadra through because it splits a signal. I shouldn't say it splits. It duplicates a signal into four different identical signals inside this box. So that one signal that's coming out of the Octatrack goes into the one port on the back of this, and then it goes from that, it's duplicated into four other identical signal chains, and one of those goes to each of these instruments. So one to the analog rhythm, one to the Digitone, one to the Digitact, and one to the analog four. So they're all getting exactly the same message. So if we want everyone to start at the same time, they would all get that same message from the Octatrack. Push start, they all start at exactly the same time. Now, each one of those is taking a signal in from this, and each one of these four signals that was duplicated within this box is going out to those different ones. Now, what happens if we want something to receive signals from two different places? So for example, the Digitact in my setup is being controlled, the volume of each channel, the send of the reverb and the send of the delay and the pitch are all being controlled from the Novation launch control. That signal needs to get into the Digitact, and so does the signal from the Octatrack, but there's only one input. There's only one MIDI in. So in that case, we use another one of these boxes that looks really similar to the first one because it's from the same company. These are from all different companies. And this is called a MIDI merger. And what this does is it takes two signals from two different locations on two different MIDI cables. It merges them into now one combined signal. And then there's two outputs. So that combined signal can go to two different places if we wanted to. I only use one in my setup. So I have the signal from the Octatrack coming into here, and I have the signal from the MIDI controller coming into here. They merge together, and then that one single cable goes to the MIDI in on the back of the Digitact. So that way it's getting both signal paths into one area. Now, it's possible then afterwards, if you need to, you could then split that into more. So this has two outs. If you wanted five different things or eight different things to get that same combined signal, you can use then another MIDI like this quadra through or a different size through box. They come in all different sizes. There's one that I saw that is from a different company that is a one in 25 out. So you can have one signal that can be divided to 25 different MIDI instruments at the same time. So let's say you have a whole room full of synthesizers and you want them all to start at the same time when you push play on the kind of master unit of your setup. You can do that with a 25 multiplier. I don't want to say splitter because it isn't splitting the signal at all. It's duplicating the signal into 25 duplicates of that same signal that was coming in. Now, another unique scenario that I have in my setup is that with the Digitact, it's being controlled by this launch control. The launch control is a USB MIDI device. And I said we weren't going to talk about USB, but this is the one little exception. So the launch control has an output on it that looks like this end of a MIDI cable. So it's looking for an input on the other side. It's looking for a MIDI host. Now, traditionally, you would connect the launch control to your computer so that you could control, let's say, Ableton Live, or you could control a VST within whatever DAW you use. Then in that case, the computer is acting as the MIDI host. In my setup, there is no computer, so I want to make sure that I could find a way to have a MIDI host without actually having to use a whole computer just to do something like that. Fortunately, there is a MIDI USB host box. I'm talking all about little boxes today. What this box does is you'll notice it has an input here that would take this cable into it. So that takes the MIDI signal in from my controller. Inside this box, it converts it from a USB MIDI signal into a DIN MIDI signal. And then I connect a DIN MIDI cable into the MIDI out. And then this goes to my Digitech. So it's a way to convert a USB MIDI signal to a DIN MIDI signal when you have a controller that has a USB out and a device that you want it to control that only has a DIN MIDI in. These boxes are very handy for just that scenario. Now, what I use in my setup is actually a combination of these boxes. So I'll just talk you through the whole signal path so you can see why this got a little complicated as I was setting it up, but hopefully now it's gonna make sense. My signal comes out of the Octatrack and gets multiplied by this quad box. One of those quad signals then goes into this merger headed towards the Digitech. My USB MIDI comes out of my launch control into this USB host, and then this DIN MIDI out from the USB host goes into the other input of the merger. So now I have the Octatrack signal in one, the controller signal in the other, getting merged into one signal, and then that single cable goes into the Digitech, into the one input on the back of the Digitech. So sometimes it takes some creative solutioning to figure out where you need to split, where you need to merge, and where you can run things in a daisy chain from an into from an input to a through going to the next thing. All of that has to keep in mind what I mentioned at the beginning, that these the signal flow of MIDI is monodirectional, so it's only going to go from one side to another wherever you're sending it to, and from there you can pass it on to something else. You can keep it going in that one direction, but the information won't go back the other way, and it won't combine inside the boxes. So if you need it to combine, you need a merger, and if you need to switch it from USB MIDI to DIN MIDI, you're going to need the USB host box. So depending on how you have your setup and depending on what pieces of equipment you have and the ways you want to control it, you're going to use different combinations of this. I like to keep in my drawers down here different versions of these boxes so that when I do different setups, I can control them in different ways. The final piece of the MIDI signal path in my setup is for the PC-12. The PC-12 is controlling the Octatrack, so the signal needed to go from DIN MIDI, which is on the side of the PC-12, to the in port on the Octatrack. Nothing else was going in because that's where the signal was originating. But in order for this to work properly, the Octatrack has to be able to speak back to this. So I took one of those duplicated signals from the quadra through and I put it back into here. So this is listening to the Octatrack and it's also talking to the Octatrack. The only way to make DIN MIDI bidirectional is with two cables. Out from here, into here, then back out from here, into here. So it's one directional in each way, and that makes the whole signal flow bidirectional. Makes it a little bit more complicated than if it was USB MIDI, but these aren't USB MIDI devices. So that's basically it for the MIDI setup and how I get the signal flow to go. Just keep in mind as you're setting yours up, one directional flow, making sure that you combine where you need to and duplicate where you need to, and make sure that you have each device set up to talk to the device you want it to talk to by telling it which of the 16 channels to listen on. Give each device a number. Try to keep that number the same so that way you always know what it is. You know, maybe this one is always number 10. So no matter what you plug into it, you know that if you want it to talk to the Digitech, you say, send this out on 10, because I know that's what the Digitech is listening on. So that way you can get it all set up that way. I hope you got something out of this video. If you did, I'd love a like, a share, subscribe, pass this on to your friends, and hopefully use the information that you got to help make your setup better. The next video I do is going to be a similar thing, but we're going to be talking about the audio path, because this is the MIDI path. The audio path is different, going through all these different instruments, combining in certain areas, coming out the other side. So I want to do one on that coming up here soon. If you've got any ideas for any other videos that you'd like to see, please put them in the comments down below. I would love to hear what you get out of these and what you would like to see out of these. And I'm more than happy to help if I'm able to. Share what I've learned in my trial and error, so you don't have to commit the same errors, hopefully, and we can learn through this together. And if you've got some different ways to do this or some different ideas about how to connect things, I'd love to hear about those in the comments too, because I'm always interested in learning new stuff as well. So let's share some of that information back and forth and pass it on to the people we know. Thank you very much for listening again. Love to have you here, and hope to see you back again in another video. Thanks very much. Have a great rest of your day. Peace.